Hello everyone. Welcome to the IMF Explainer series. I'm Githika Malhotra, Research Manager at Nicore Associates, and I will be discussing the potential challenges to bring an end to this pandemic. First and foremost is the prospect of the virus mutating rapidly, making it essential for us to stay ahead of the changing epidemiology, develop vaccines to prevent transmission, and address new entrants. However, scaling up production to meet global demand is a monumental challenge in itself. COVID-19 vaccine production lags far behind its demand, especially from the developing countries. Even if vaccines are produced to meet the global demand, providing everyone with vaccines by 2022 requires coordinated global action with full transparency in procurement and delivery process. Also, cooperation on trade is crucial to ensure free cross-border flows and increased supplies of raw materials and finished vaccines. Further, to avoid a scenario where developing economies recover much more slowly than advanced nations, there is a dire need to ensure fair, equitable, and affordable access to vaccines globally, particularly to the low-income economies. Vaccine nationalism, where countries prioritize their domestic vaccination needs, leads to limiting the stock available to poorer countries to vaccinate their healthcare workers and high-risk populations. Unequal allocation of vaccines also threatens global economic recovery that could cost the global economy up to $1.2 trillion per year in GDP. Lastly, deployment of vaccines is also hampered by vaccine hesitancy, which is potentially leading to refusal or delayed acceptance of COVID-19 vaccines. Issues pertaining to the speed at which the vaccines have been developed raise concerns that the trials were rushed and regulatory standards relaxed. Moreover, theories about COVID-19 vaccines are being widely circulated on unregulated social media platforms. Therefore, to achieve widespread uptake, public confidence in vaccines and vaccination programs needs to be increased. Thank you.